So we are starting SQL once again, and now we'll see that how to open once again. So you will type out here SQL or MySQL something. Okay, MySQL command line client will appear. Okay, just write MySQL command line client, click on it, and then it will open for you. Okay, so when it will be opened in this way, you have to give the password and you will enter inside the MySQL arena. Understood? And then you can minimize maximize the screen, and you can come up with this one. Okay, MySQL. So what was our database actually? So you can see out there, if you forget your database name, show databases. Okay, show databases, it will display the name of the database. Yes, our database was master, so you will do use master. All right, then semicolon, database changed. Now the thing is that how to see the tables, you can give show. Okay, tables. All right, show tables. Okay, sure. Now these are the tables which we had left, which we had left for functioning. Okay, now the record of the tables can be seen in this way. Select star from, okay, select star from a student. Okay, then it will display you all the records available out here. So there are 5 records you can see out here. Now we will see certain ways to insert once more. Okay, how to insert record into it. So we will do normally in this way, insert into a table name student. Okay, student values. Okay, values, then we will give the other values. So SID, suppose I am giving 145, and then name say Rajesh Jain. Okay, Rajesh Jain is from Delhi. Okay, Delhi. Okay, and then he is what for gender, male. All right, date of birth is 2000-09-18, 18 September 2000, and then marks is 67. All right, so we are closing this one and then enter this one. Then there is an error. Okay, check the manual, that is the thing. So here use near this stop somewhere the error is. So here is the error. You can see out a dot has been inserted instead of comma. So here what will happen, we will just insert the dot. Okay, in this way, if there is any error is there, you can also overcome. All right, now press enter. Okay, then the query okay means one record has been inserted. The select, okay, star from, be sure, select star from student. Okay, what is happening, this record, one more record, Rajesh Jain, has been included out here. Okay, sorted order. Okay, that is the thing. So now see, insert is having several other syntaxes also. Okay, what could you do in this way also, insert into, in this way also you can do insert into student, and then student, and then don't give values out here. Previous one was different. Okay, previous one was what we have given in this way. Okay, insert into student values. Now what we are doing, okay, we are not doing in this way, insert into student, we are keeping up to here. Okay, then we are giving the name of the fields we do have. What we are having, SID, comma, name, comma, address, comma, gender, comma, DOB, comma, marks. Okay, and marks, then we are closing this one. Then we are putting the values in a separate bracket out here. Say 156, comma, Sujal, okay, Kumar. Okay, Kumar, and then comma. Then what will you give? Address again, say from Siliguri he is. Siliguri, and then comma, address is over, and gender is male. Okay, and then comma, date of birth is 2001-04-19. All right, 19th April 2001, and comma, this is marks is suppose 78. Okay, close it. Okay, and then put a semicolon. This is the another syntax of insert. Okay, so where the field names will be given first, and then the values will be given in a separate bracket. All right, so you can insert it also. Then you can select, okay, star from student. All right, student, then what will happen, you see out here, so the one more record has been inserted out here. So the thing is that that day also I told you how to check the field name and all. You just type description and then student, the table name, and then student, and then semicolon. Then what will happen, it will show you the description. So the field name you can understand easily from here, and SID is having the primary key attribute, which does not allow you to enter any kind of duplicate values. All right. Now at present the data that we had in the table, select star from a student, we can see easily how many data are there, student are there. So we'll say this, get this, how many, 3 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, these things are there. All right, now we will see a bit of update command also from here. Now say whenever we want to update, what will you do? Update student set. Okay, set as a marks equals to, say marks equals to, say 50, set marks equals to 50, where SID equals to 124. Then what will happen in this case? We are just modifying the marks of Sanjay Kumar, who's having the SID 124 up to 92. All right, now the thing is that if we are entering, the thing is that, okay, entering, then the modification will take place. So how you will understand, select star from student, you will see out here Sanjay Kumar marks has been changed into 50. This is the kind of modification. Now say we are talking about the multiple columns. Okay, if the updation to be done with the multiple column, the same things will be used on this one. Suppose say I will change the Delhi, is a spelling mistake out here, this I will make Delhi, and the date of birth say also to be changed into say 18th of August. All right, so for the Rajesh Jain, that is 145. Then update student, and then what will have to gonna set, set what, set address. Okay, address, because there is a mistake, semicolon has been inserted by mistake. Address equals to say Delhi. Okay, D-E-L-H-I, you can use like also, Delhi, and sorry, not and, you have to give comma out here, and say DOB equals to say 2000 August. Okay, and that will be 18th of August, not September, 18th of August. Okay, and then what you have to do, where you can write also name like, okay, what, Rajesh Jain. Okay, the Rajesh Jain, if it is, then you can do, or you can do, what can you do, you can use this SID, that is the unique key also, JIN, Rajesh Jain. All right, semicolon. All right, now we are pressing enter, this has been taken place. Now how will you check? Again, you do select star from student, you see out here it has, previously it was semicolon, now it is appearing Delhi, and then it is coming 67 out here, you can see, the 18th of August instead of 18th of September, it is appearing. Fine. So now the thing is that in this way also you can do the update command, but updation will be done, updation can be done also by using the unique key. Normally we use the unique key, but here I have used the Rajesh Jain as the things, because it is specific out here, no other Rajesh Jains are there. This, but if one more Rajesh Jain would have been there, in that case you have no way, you have to use the SID only. That is the thing. So otherwise that Rajesh Jain, which I'm not supposed to change, that one also will be changed. So what will happen? The data inconsistency will appear. Okay, so that's why it is better to do with the Rajesh, the primary key field, but here we have done with Rajesh Jain, since it is very specific out here. All right, so that is the thing. So now you will see that how to update a value with a null value. Okay, so I'm doing here update. Okay, update student. Okay, set, okay, gender equals to null. Okay, what is that called? Null means nothing. Gender equals to null. Okay, so here it is. What is the demonstration out here? How to update the multiple values. So whenever you will give the field name, you have to use the comma and all. All right. So gender equals to null, where SID. Not, will not use gender. We will just use address. Address equals to null, where SID equals to 156. Okay, so his address will be null. Okay, that is the thing. So you see I'm entering now. So now you see the status of this particular record. Okay, select star from student, you do, it has become null now. Okay, so now in this way the null record you have done. Okay, so now the thing is that how will you display the null? So select, okay, select star from, okay, student, okay, a student address equals to null. If you give, it will be wrong. Address is null, this particular constraint to be used. All right, enter. So the only the null record has been displayed. So we have seen that how the record to be updated with null value, and whenever you are displaying the null record by using the select command, you have taken select star from student where address is null. So that means only the null record has been displayed. Now I'll show you the operator that how to display the record which are not null. Okay, so what you have to do is simply you have to write is not null. All right, then you see every record will be displayed. Instead, null has not been displayed. So not is actually the inverting constraint. All right, this is called inverted constraint. Okay, so the thing where it is true, because null is not null means wherever it is showing it is not null, that has been displayed out here. So the thing is that whenever you have been asked to say the display the null value, don't give equals, always use the is constraint and is not constraint. Is not constraint the records which does not have any null value. Now you see how the thing is that you have seen how to make the data null. Okay, and now you will see that how to update it. Okay, at the null value, update okay, student, okay, address, set address equals to, say I'm giving out here, say bagdogra, okay, update student set address equals to bagdogra, and the null value is which one, that is of what you call, let us see who's having the null value, Sujal Kumar, okay, where SID equals to what, 156. Okay, so the null value will get updated with the or you can give the things SID where you can give the things also where the address is null, that also can be given. Okay, so where SID goes to 56 we have done, and now select a star from student also do, okay, semicolon, you can see it has been changed into bagdogra, which was null before, it has been updated. So these are the certain things about the updation. Okay, and you can see out here you can increase the marks also. Those who are living in Delhi, their marks will be increased by 5 marks. Okay, so select update a student, okay, student, okay, update student, set marks equals to, okay, marks plus how much by 10, will enter by 10, okay, marks equals to marks by 10, okay, where address equals to, or address like Delhi. Okay, for the string we can use the equals to also, we can use the like also, Delhi. Okay, you enter a semicolon. Okay, now you can see there's an error, marks field is not there, set marks equals to where address, update student, is that, what is the error out here, NARX it has become, I see, I'm very sorry, it has become NARX, that's why the error was coming, otherwise it is fine, there's no problem, we'll just change into N and then make it into marks. Okay, now press enter, it has been changed, you will see. So what was the value of Delhi, 80 and 67, it will become 90 and 77, I believe. Okay, now you see the select staff of student, yes, it is quite rightly, the marks has been increased by 10 and 10, you can compare the data from here and over here. Okay, so this is the certain things about the update. Okay, so now say I'm showing you the alias, how the alias to be added with the field name. Select name. Okay, suppose you have given name of the student. Okay, name of the students. Okay, then name. Okay, and comma. So this is the registration number, ID number you can give, ID number, SID, okay, SID, ID number double quote closed, and you can give in the single quote also, doesn't matter, SID, okay, from student, all right. So the thing is that you can give out here, you can see out here, this heading has been changed. This is called actually the alias printing, okay, that is the name of the student's name, and ID number, SID number. So one variation out here you can show out here. Okay, select. Okay, select. Suppose you are giving only name. If it is a single data, suppose you are giving name, then you have given name. All right, comma, registration, and then you have given SID, and then you have given from what you call a student. Okay, you see out here. So there is an error. Now see the thing, a bit of alias printing, select name and name, that this name is not the field name and registration is also not the field name. Field name is actually what, this one, select star from student. All right, this is the field name. So you just select, spelling is wrong. Okay, we are just coming out to this select. All right, now you see the select name. Okay, name is name. Okay, and SID registration, the original field name is this, but we have changed the heading of the field name. That is actually the calling the alias out here. So first the field name to be given and then the alias, whatever it is. It can be done in this way also. Can be done in this way also. Select name, suppose you have not given any double quote. Okay, suppose you make it in this way, SID, and then this to be given in this way. Okay, suppose single thing you have given out here, then also what will happen, let's see. Okay, enter. Okay, and then also means like if you are giving single quote, if you are giving the single letter, single word, no need to give the quotes also. Okay, no need to give the quotes also. Now suppose if it is more than one word, let's say select and then I am to print name. Okay, name, suppose I have to print in this way, name of the student. Okay, you can give either single quote, name of the student. Okay, this alias I have to add, and then registration number will be like this. I will do like this. Registration number, REGISTRATION, registration, registration number. All right, this alias to be added. So what is happening now, the heading will be changed. Instead of the field heading, these things will to appear. Now one more word is there that I have to give the single quote. All right, so you see name of the student has been changed and registration ID also has been changed. Okay, now you can give in this way also. You see the all three ways, name as name of the student, as clause also you can use out here. And then here you can give also the as clause. Okay, that is also is acceptable. Okay, but if you don't give, nothing will happen. So I'm showing you the all three types of aliases that can be added as the heading of the certain field. All right, so name of the students. In this way, other fields also, if you want, you can add. Suppose if you want out here comma then address. Okay, here you give address of the student, address of the student. Okay, this one you want to add. So and then you have given the single quote and then you have given address. Okay, sorry, address. Okay, address, fine. So the thing is that address also will be printed. I'm sorry, not this one, address of the student. And then we have to give the first of all we have to give the field name, then we have to give the alias. Okay, that is to be, you have to keep in mind. Okay, so that is an error. So I'm giving out here address. Okay, see, address, address of the student. All right, that was not correct, incorrect query. So now this is the correct. So first of all, your field name to come, then the alias should come. All right, so the thing is that name of the student has come, registration number has come, address of the student also has come. So in this way, all the fields you can take the alias. All right, so the three ways I have shown you. If it is not a, if it is a single word, no need to give the single quote. If it is more than one word, then you have to give the single quote or double quote. Or you can use as also. Without as also, it is possible that you have seen it. All right, that is the thing. Fine. The thing is that now I will show you how to delete the record. Okay, select star from, okay, from student. Okay, see, SQL is not case sensitive. You can get the capital letter also, nothing will happen. All right, now the thing is that how to delete. Okay, delete, okay, sorry, delete from, okay, delete from, okay, student. What you want to delete? Suppose 347 random issue, I want to delete. Okay, select delete from student. Okay, so how to do this? Where SID equals to 156. To be very careful, the wrong record should not be deleted. Sorry, 156. No, I have to give 347. All right, then it will be deleted. Okay, you see now, select okay star from student. Sorry, from student. Excuse me, student, and then semicolon. You see that Ranu Mishra is not there. And if you this record has been deleted. Now suppose you want to delete this record who is living in Bagdogra. All right, delete from student where you can give out here address. Okay, like okay Bagdogra, or address equals to Bagdogra also you can give Bagdogra, but string should match entirely. A string should match entirely what is given under the certain field. So Bagdogra record I want to remove, okay, from here. So you check out here now the Bagdogra record whether it has been deleted or not. So select star from student that I'm giving. So it is confirming that the Ranu Mishra and that particular record has been deleted, which So what we are talking about, the record that is Bagdogra has been deleted. So this is the thing. So what is the syntax for the delete command? Delete from student, delete from, all right, delete from the table name where address like Bagdogra or address equals to Bagdogra can be given. So there are certain format of the, you have seen it, update set, okay, delete from, this kind of things you have to use. Select star from table name, this thing that you have to give. All right, now see, I will use certain not operator little bit, okay. So now I want to display the records whose address is not Kalimpong. All right, so the thing is that how I will do that. Select a star from student, okay, where address is not equals to, this is called is not equals to, okay, Kalimpong, okay, that is the thing, and then I'm giving semicolon. So the thing is that records that have been displayed apart from Kalimpong, all right, that is the thing. So that is the use of the not operator, okay. And then instead, if you want to use the not operator itself, the identical result, not this one. Select star from student, that is incorrect one. Not operator has not been used out here, I'm sorry. Okay, now you see the things how this is to be used, right? Okay, just a minute. So the thing is that is not equals, this one will be Kalimpong to be used. So whomsoever address is not Kalimpong, that one will be displayed. You don't consider this particular query, it is something different. All right, it is different. Okay, so select star from student where address not equals to Kalimpong. All right, so now suppose you want to display, you want to insert one more record. I want to insert into values within bracket, then I'll give 213 comma Rajni Mishra, and then address is Siliguri, okay, and then comma, then date of birth is gender is female, okay, date of birth is 2007-09-13, all right, and then some more records will enter, okay, and then your marks is say 56, all right, say, and then semicolon, then we have inserted data, select star from student, and it has been displayed student, okay. So the thing is that it is showing me the data. So there are altogether how many records, there are 5 records altogether. So these are the things, marks has been displayed out here, okay. So the thing is that one command is there, that is the that is actually the alter table command, that is called alter table, just to change the structure of the table. Suppose what you have to do, if you want to add one more field, say I want to add a field known as say blood group, all right, so alter table alter student, okay, so alter table, what is the name, student, okay, add, what is the thing, add blood group BLD, blood group, and data type is say care, and then say care 5 I am adding, all right. Now you see semicolon, alter table student, add BLD as blood group, okay, and care 5. So now you see this has been added. Now you see the, what is the status of this particular blood group, okay. Now you see the thing, select star from student, this is the alter command we are starting now. So alter command is used to modify the definition of a table by modifying the definition of its columns. It is also used to perform the following operations: to add a column to an existing table, to rename any existing column, okay, to change the data type of any column, or to modify its size, to remove or physically delete a column. All right, these are things, power jobs have been performed by the alter table command. Now you see select star from student, now you see the things, all it has appeared null, okay. Now how will you do? You have to do update, okay, update student, okay. Update student set BLD, since it's a character data, say you have given the B positive, okay, B positive is the blood group. Where SID equals to 121. So what will happen in this way, you have to, then if you do select star from student, it will show you that has been updated. So in this way, null data to be updated. All right. So the thing is that this particular thing, so when you have entered, when you are adding the value, it is actually added with a null value. You see out the behaviorally no value has been added. So now one by one you have to update the record. So how to do so, you have to give this particular command. So it will not take much time. So you press the up arrow key, the previous one will come. Now you give say only say it is a positive. Then you do one thing, SID equals to 124. What will happen? 124. Okay, now you delete this one. Okay, one is happening. Then again you go for next data is our 145, and then here you come and change it to say O positive. All right, O positive. Okay, enter. It has been inserted. Now you see it is next data is 213. Just if is the up arrow, your editing job will be done very fast. Okay, and then say it is a negative. Fine, I'm entering a negative. Okay, and pressing here, so enter. So here we are keeping the a negative only, and this one 356, because two people can have the same blood group. And then after 213 we are having the 356, and then enter, and then we will see that here it is again a positive. We will keep a positive or AB positive also you can keep, and then this data will be 451. So 451 you can see out here, and press enter. So what has happened, all the null values have been inserted and have been updated. Okay, this is an entire use of the update command as well as the alter command, and I've shown you how to add a column. What is the command for this? The thing is that this is actually alter table name, add column and size. Okay, and data type and size. So that is the syntax for the alter command. What is the thing? Alter table name, add is the keyword, name of the field. Okay, and its data type and size. This is the alter table. So I've already told you alter can add a column, rename a column, change the data type or modify a column, or you can remove a column also. Okay, so the thing is that here now let us check whether it has been changed or not. So select, you give here always for confirm, you give the command select star from the table name. All right, clear. So that is the thing. So this is all you have changed that we have edited out here. You can see nicely. So this is the update command that I have taught you today. All right. So B plus, A positive, O positive, A minus, A plus. Okay. That is the thing. So with respect to blood group, if you want to see the data, select star. Okay. From a student. Okay. Where BLD like, I have taken the cat tech data. That's why BLD like say A. Negative. All right, so those data will be shown out here. Okay, you see the negative data only has come. So in this way the where clause you can use out here in order to set a criteria. Fine. So now the thing is that, so we will see that, you see that once the confirming the description of structure. All right, description, student will give student out here semicolon, it is showing the primary key. Now the thing is that alter table, I'm just removing the primary key from here. Alter table or the student, then drop, okay, primary key. Just with this command you will see that the primary key will be removed. All right, so you see how the six was affected. Now you check the description of the table, you will see that this PRI word will not be there. Okay, description, you see the PRI has been removed. All right, that is the things. So now the thing is that once you have taken out this one, you may have to add also. So alter table, okay, student, okay, add primary key, add primary key SID type is integer. All right, semicolon. Okay, sorry, you have error. What is the error that you have to see? Integer. Okay, a key SID, not the things, a key SID semicolon. Just a minute. Yes. So the thing is that these two are incorrect syntax. I'm very sorry. Okay, alter table student at primary key, then within bracket you have to give the field name. All right, so as the integer already been chosen, integers has already been given to this particular field, the data type. Okay, so no need to give it once again. So that's why it was showing error, primary key, and the second one it was correct, but I did not put it into the bracket. So that is also to be noted down. So in this way you can drop the primary key and you can add it up. How will you confirm? Give the description command once again. Okay, you see primary has appeared once again. So today is this much. We will come more up with in the next class.